All right, so in the previous videos in this playlist, we saw how to create a WebSocket server, put it on the cloud, and then connect clients and exchange information between them. And the examples that we have done have been very simple text messages, but I would like to show you examples of how to use this technique to exchange more nuanced information, more that is richer and creates more interactive activity, more interactive experiences. So what we're going to do in the next couple videos is that we're going to create some kind of sketch, some kind of canvas where we can click around and have an object like a circle, for example, chase that motion. But I would like to build up so that that motion of the circle is synchronized across everyone who is connected to the same sketch and the same server. So in a way, what we're going to do is this moving circle that is going to have its motion coordinated in many different clients. So if we all connected to the same place, we would all see the same motion of the circle being clicked by people. So in this particular video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create just that thing, the canvas object with the moving circle, etc., without connecting it to the server. And then in the next video, I will explain how to add code that will connect it to the Echo server that we have developed in the previous video and coordinate this motion between different clients. For this, I'm going to be using P5.js, which I have not explained in my channel, but it's a super nice, extremely rich project, which is basically the JavaScript version of the processing project. And this is really good for creating code that lives on websites, but it's interactive and it's very graphics oriented. If you want to learn more about using P5.js and the online editor, I very, very strongly recommend you check Daniel Schiffman's videos on his YouTube channel, The Coding Train. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the editor and I'm going to log in with my information so that I can create a new project that I'm going to call what am I going to call? Synchronized. Sync chasing ball, for example. That is a terrible name. But regardless, so I'm going to create this canvas, and then I'm going to draw a circle at the center of the screen. So that's going to be width divided by 2, height divided by 2, and for example, 20. And if I run this code, you can see that I get the circle here at the center of the screen. Now, what I would like to do is I would like to create some kind of animation where as I click in different areas of the screen, the ball starts approaching those areas. So what I'm going to do, that kind of motion that is smooths into a target position is typically referred to as easing. And the way I'm going to do that is by maintaining two variables in my global scope, which is going to be, one is going to be where the ball is at any given time, and the other one is going to be where the ball is heading towards at any given time. And then every frame I will approximate the location of where it is to the location where it should be. And every time I click on the screen, I will change the location of where I want it to be. So what is that going to look like? Well, I'm going to create a variable which is going to be called position. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to create an object, a JavaScript object that is going to have two properties, x, which I'm going to initialize to 0, for example, and y that I'm also going to initialize to 0. So that's going to be the current position. Current ball position. And now the other one that I'm going to create is target ball position. So same thing. So let target is going to be an object that is going to have x 0, for example, and y is also going to be 0. Why am I creating an object and not just having random variables one after the other? Well, in JavaScript world, it's considered nice to have objects, because now I can just refer to this position as position.x or position.y, and everything is very object-oriented in JavaScript, that's one thing. But also, because I would like to use this example to explain the notion of exchanging JSON data via WebSockets, which is a very, very common scenario. So it will make it much easier for us to communicate and to exchange this data between different clients. So now, here in the circle, what I need to do is I need to say, well, what I need to do is I need to draw my circle at position.x, at position.y. If I run that, the circle shows up at 0, 0, that's correct. And then what I would like to do now is I would like to say, whenever the mouse is clicked, function mouse clicked, whenever the mouse is clicked, all right, I would like to replace target with a new object that is going to have x is going to be the value of mouse x, and y is going to be the value of mouse y. And I'm going to print something to the console just to make sure that this is working. So new target is, and then for example, target. Let's see if this works. I'm going to run this code. I'm going to execute this code. And then when I click here, new target is object. Okay, so I need to console log target. And then I believe this will break down. So now I'm going to click here. New target is these pixels and these pixels. So this one is these pixels and these pixels. Okay, so that is looking great, but still not moving the actual ball. So what I need to do now is I need to write here some code where every frame, what I need to do is I need to change the value of position and make it closer to whatever it wants to be according to target. So is position into target. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to say position, the value of position x should be the value of target.x minus position.x multiplied by a small factor. So for example, 0.1 here. And I'm going to do the same for y. So this is going to be y and y and y. And if I run this code, I believe that I should be clicking here and here and here and here. All right. So I can actually control this. So for example, let me say global parameters. And I'm going to, let me say, for example, const easing speed is going to be, for example, 0.5. And then I'm going to write here easing speed. And here is going to be easing speed. Okay, I'm going to run this again. And then, okay. So basically what I'm doing is every frame to the x and the y values of the position, I am adding the difference between where the ball is and what it should be, multiplied by a very small value. Because if I were to add the difference, then it would immediately get to that point. So this is typically, this kind of technique is referred to as easing a value. All right. Okay. And just because I feel like this today, I'm going to play a little bit with the colors and the stuff, because it's, I don't really like it that much. So how about we do something where we say, let's say that the background, it's going to be black, and then there's going to be no stroke, and the fill color is going to be white, for example. Okay, and then here in the background, instead of doing so the fill color is going to be white here. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is, instead of clearing the background, What I'm going to do is that every frame, I'm going to do a fill color of black that is going to be very transparent. And then I'm going to draw a rectangle from 0, 0 to width and height. I basically want to create this kind of, you know, this like shading effect, this blur effect between the trajectories of, and I actually want to make it a little bit more transparent so that I see the, so that the footprints, you see, I don't know if you can notice, but you can see the trace of this motion. Okay. All right. So I'm kind of liking this a lot. All right. So, something that I'm going to do is that just to be the final thing is that whenever I'm going to actually remove this from mouse clicked, and I'm going to create a new function that I'm going to call set target X and Y. And whenever anybody calls that, what I would like to do is replace target with the value of X being, I'm just going to write here X position now. Tx and ty, just so that it's a bit easier to read. So tx, and then the value of y is going to be ty. I'm going to do that because then what I would like to do is that whenever somebody clicks with the mouse, what I would like to do is I would like to set the target to mouse x and mouse y. All right. That doesn't really make a difference for us right now, but it will make a slight difference whenever we start implementing this in coordination with all the other clients with the server. Okay. All right. So I think at this point we have the basic project that we want, the sync chasing ball, and with that, I think we're ready to move on to the next video where. What I'm going to do is I'm going to hook this project up to the Echo server that we had in Glitch, and then I'm going to be able to coordinate the motion of two. So I'm going to be able to coordinate the motion of two of these sketches next to each other. All right. I'm going to be able to have two clients, and then whenever each one of them moves the ball around, then the motion is going to be coordinated between those two because they're going to have the WebSocket server in the middle exchanging the target position of the ball. All right. Okay. So let's move on to the next video and see how to make that happen.